Let's look at the atomic structure for chlorine, that's Cl, on the periodic table. And we're going to use a Bohr diagram to help us visualize the structure of the chlorine atom. Starting off, we have 17 as the atomic number. What that means is that the atomic number, that's equal to the number of protons. So we have 17 protons here in the nucleus of the chlorine atom. Because chlorine is a neutral element, and all of the elements listed on the periodic table, they're listed as neutral. Number of protons equals the number of electrons. So we have 17 protons in the nucleus, and then in these energy levels here, we have 17 electrons around the nucleus. Let's use the periodic table to visualize how we put these electrons into these energy levels. So we have a total of 17 electrons in the first period. This is the first energy level. We can put 1, 2, but then that's full. So here's the 2 in the first energy level. Next, we need to go to the second energy level, second period here on the periodic table. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. So we can put 8 in that second energy level there. So there's 8. So far we have 8 plus the 2, 10 electrons. Remember, we have 17. So we go to the third energy level here, third period, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. And right here on the periodic table, that's chlorine. So we put 7 electrons here in the highest energy level, in the third energy level, 2, 4, 6, 7. Add all of the electrons up, you'll get 17. These electrons in the highest energy level are called valence electrons, and they're important in chemical bonding. If you need help writing the electron configuration for chlorine here, or figuring out the number of neutrons, there's a link at the end of this video. This is Dr. B with the Bohr diagram for the chlorine atom. Thanks for watching.